journey has been. Because, like I said, this was the first group that came through here, came through PE, and so they really were my experiment. I really did cut my teeth on them quite a lot, and to have a very forgiving group of people around you and a very supportive group makes such a difference. And you'll know that when you have experiences that are new and you've got people who are there, both from Pops of Possibility itself, from the organization itself, and from the group, it's been a phenomenal experience. And, you know, for the business leaders, trusting an uncertain leader down an unknown path is quite a thing to do. And that's really what they did. They took an uncertain leader, who was me, they didn't know where they were going, and they went anyway. And to invest your own time and your own effort in that is remarkable. And for the principals, allowing a stranger to come into your school and making yourselves vulnerable to that person really shows a strength of character, because there's not a lot of people who can do that. And what I've learned is that the partnership only ever goes as far and as fast as the principal allows. And often we have principals who put the brakes on and don't want to allow it to go any further. And that's where the partnership just stops. But in this room are five principals who were willing, and they were able, and they did. And that was what made those partnerships successful. And so because I was sitting on my bed this afternoon thinking, I had to think of things that how this is impacted me, so I've actually made a list. Things that I've learned, it's about being open and vulnerable. It's about trusting the process. I knew the process in theory. I knew the process in a book, on a brochure. I knew the you process. I knew, you know, what do we do and when and the timings and everything, but I didn't know it and I had to trust it. Holding your own beliefs gently is something which has become very real for me this year. And not thrusting them on anyone else, but waiting for them to make their own discoveries. Being non-judgmental, what we learn in times of thinking. Listen without judgment. Being gentle. Practicing patience when the journals don't come. Showing grace and receiving grace. And for me, last year was a very rough year on a personal level. And the grace that was shown by Parks of Possibility, by Symphonia, the organization itself, was such a learning experience for me. Because I came from a very difficult corporate environment where you were nailed for everything that you did wrong. And to have somebody say to me, it's actually okay, and it will be all right, but how can we fix this, was remarkable. It was such a different experience. Listening. Pausing. And this actually, my book, my PFP book, for those of you who are at Rawls Consulting, community building, do you remember these pieces of paper? Now, for those of you who went there, we had to write on the top of this, I am the possibility of. And you had to write what you were the possibility of. And mine was very personal about my son. And putting it out there and saying, I am the possibility of him being able to do all of these things, has meant that, in fact, that stuff has already started coming true. It's already starting to happen. Because I put it out there, because I allowed myself to think, I could be the possibility of this child actually being anything. And what I've observed this year has been remarkable. I've observed open hearts. I've observed creativity, humbleness, like you in bucket loads that you wouldn't believe. People who pitch up day after day after day. And I'm not only talking about the principals, I'm talking about the business leaders as well, who just take for granted that they're just going to be there and they're just going to do the thing over and over. And they do it, and they do it with humbleness. Passion and dedication in unexpected places. I think it was Garth, I think you said that your dinner table conversations have changed. And that's been a sister reality for me as well, where part of the reason why I wanted to become involved in this was because I was so tired of being on the receiving end of bad education, blah, blah, blah. You know, soapbox out from under the table and firmly on it. and realizing that in fact the system, the people in the system are not broken. There are no broken people. But there are people who have passion and dedication who are working towards making things better. And then we were on a, our PFP community has a national call, and one of the ladies on the call, I think it was Rosemary, who spoke about bravery unraveling. And it's a phrase that just struck me. I wrote it down because it really caught me. And that's exactly what I see here. I see bravery and the show unraveling, and vulnerability is exposed, and then being built up again to something different, and to a different reality, which is wonderful to watch. So I have some certificates here, which I'm going to be giving you, and our partners are speaking a lot about appreciation, so let me just explain to you what an appreciation is, for those of you who are non-partners. So an appreciation is something that is a gift that we give to somebody else. An appreciation is not, well, I like your shirt. Appreciation is something where I appreciate a quality or a value that I see in you. And the person who receives the appreciation receives it with grace and says thank you. And if they're brave, they say, tell me more. So appreciation is a big part of what we do at PFP, and it's a very important part of what we do because we really do build up and edify. So, and I call your name, if you wouldn't mind coming up. Bill, top of the list. So, Bill, what I really appreciate about you is I appreciate your ability to stay the course, to be so self-aware in an environment which doesn't support that of you all the time. I appreciate your dedication, I appreciate your passion, I appreciate every time I see you saying to a child, cut your hair or pull up your socks or just being you in that space. You make such a difference to people, you made a difference to me this year. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Tell me more.
Adam, I so appreciate your humor. I appreciate the fact that you can laugh at yourself, that you can say something with this absolutely deadpan expression on your face, and then I wonder if he's being serious. And he's usually joking. And I love that about you. I love the fact that it doesn't matter how hard the stuff is, you always have a smile on your face, you're always thinking about golf, you always have something else on your mind, despite the stuff that brings you down. And so I've loved working with you this year. Thank you so much. Struck me about you is your integrity. And I so appreciate the man that you are in the face of everything that you are in front of every day. I appreciate the fact that the children who are under you have a role model to look up to, who always has their best interest at heart. And I appreciate the fact that you care so much about them that you want to change their whole environment, not just the little part of it. Thank you so much. Richard, from the moment I met you, the day I met you, I thought, sure, this man is amazing. He's like a deer caught in the headlights. He doesn't know if he's going to grow. And I have watched you grow this year and over a journey that I never expected to see from you. And I so appreciate your willingness to be able to step up. I appreciate your willingness to put your head on the block and say, if a school matric pass rate doesn't improve, I'm gone. That is a massive personal sacrifice that you were prepared to make for the children who are under your care. And the fact that you are able to do that and stand here today with a matric pass rate that's gone up, with a man who physically looks different, is such an honor to you. And I really want to honor you and appreciate you for your hard work that you've done. Leon, the man of words. Leon, I love the fact that you have words for everything. That you are so expressive, and you have got such a rich history of Bethelstorp in your heart. It doesn't doesn't, it's not only in your mind, it's in your heart, and it comes out in everything that you do. You've got such a passion for your community, a passion for your children, a passion for your teachers, and I see it so clearly, and I really want to honor you for that. And I appreciate the fact that you have done this so willingly. I appreciate the fact that you keep the history. I appreciate that you have let Belinda in. I just, this year has been a remarkable. Linda, I want to say something besides energy and enthusiasm. Because that's the thing that I appreciate about you. It's just the energy and enthusiasm and the willingness just to step out over and over and over. Just step out and go, I'm going to help a child go to school. I'm going to employ children who are coming out of school who are unemployable. I'm going to step out and partner with this person who I've never met. And I'm going to expose myself and my business and everything around me. And I so appreciate that willingness. Your open heart is just so beautiful to watch. I appreciate, what I appreciate about you, God, is that firstly you listened. You listened and you didn't fix. And that in a situation where you could have gone into fix it mode, just made it so real. And it made me realize that what I do can also impact on other people. I appreciate every meeting that we had where you sat in and I don't really know what I'm doing here, but I'm doing it anyway, because it just shows such a willingness and shows an ability to show empathy and to be in a situation that you're not comfortable with. I appreciate the fact that last year was hard for you and that this year is probably going to be equally hard for you, but you're staying the course. And that shows me that you're a man of your word. And that this wholehearted businessman actually maybe is a little Russian. Ari, what I appreciate about you is your wisdom. And my notebook is filled with the little Ariisms. And I think one of my favorite ones was culture eats strategy for breakfast and lunch and dinner. And every time you opened your mouth in the class, I don't know what I was expecting, but every time you opened your mouth, I'm like, wow, this woman is so full of wisdom and so full of insights. And the fact that you just launched yourself into this program, you took on board something with your Livenbrucker, into something that you didn't know, that you were so willing to involve yourself in Cowens, and not even on a superficial level, on a very, very deep and personal level. Because when you talk values, you talk personal stuff. And so it wasn't about fixing a partial word, but it was about building a relationship, and that's the stuff that matters. And that shows me that you are able to do that in lots of other ways. Thank you so much. Godfrey, what I appreciate about you is that I feel like when we have our coaching sessions, I was being coached. That I would come out of our coaching sessions feeling lighter. I don't know how you felt, but for me, I felt lighter. And to have somebody who is older and wiser and still willing to sit and engage and listen and be available and be so open, it just drew me in. And so sometimes I would just pitch up because I would make the excuse that I haven't been able to get over you, but I would just pitch up anyway because I knew that you would make time for me. And I appreciate that. I appreciate the fact that you always put people first. That there's no second guessing what you are or who you are. That what you see is what you get. And I love that. And the last one is for Billy. And Billy is not, Billy's mom is in hospital, so he had to run off. But I want to do his appreciation anyway, and I'm going to do it to you, and you can receive it on his behalf. And what I appreciate about Billy is that he had an incredibly difficult year, and one that Bill had to kind of witness firsthand. And it was a very hard thing for him to do, to not be as involved as he would like to have been, and it hurt him in his heart. It wasn't something that he took lightly. And I appreciate the fact that despite the hardships that he underwent at work and the disruptions and the uncertainty, he was always so consistently saying, I'm so sorry, Jill, I really wanted to be there. I feel like I'm letting Bill down so bad. And he never let anyone down. And I want you to tell him that, so you can receive that. we two from here, we have come to the end of our session, but for the principals, what I'd like to initiate from here on is a principal leadership forum. That means that we're going to be meeting once a month or once every 2 months in the same format as COP, just as a group to hold things together. I think that that you are an incredibly special group of people, being my first babies. And I know that some of you are retiring soon, but that doesn't exclude you from joining us. So to our guests and to everyone who's been here, thank you so much. I